this, I was thinking about this. Bitch, on the news, yeah, they see about this. Even in the paper, they gon' read about this. Cause all of my life, training day in and night.
You guys in the locker room. Obviously, you spend a lot of time here. Coach Caruso likes to call this the family room of the football team. There's 135 lockers set up around, 4 TVs that we can watch ESPN or whatever we want, Xbox set up in the corner that we can just mess around and play. We have this main projector set up in the middle that we can watch film as a team, and Coach Caruso can easily address us in this whole area. This is the weight room, which we'll use pretty much all year round. There's 16 racks and 8 platforms that we can use to do all of our major lifts. It also gives you pretty good motivation while you're lifting as it overlooks the field.
I'm gonna look into the camera and tell my mama I love her. Cause
today is the day, is the day that I have always dreamed of. Forever, when you call me, you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream.
This is the Tommy Room. It's a room dedicated for athletes here at UST. It's a great place for the football team to come hang out or study, because I know a lot of times the library can get crowded. So this is a great place to come if you need that.
When you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world.
This is our laundry room, where we can drop our bags of laundry after practice or games. And the St. Thomas staff will do it for us.
And here's the pool where we'll use to cool down after those long 2-day practices in the fall. This is open to the student body, so they have lifeguards here that you can swim whenever you need to. It's a good workout. Stay in shape. Training room, which is accessible to us all year round. We have a full-time trainer, Jim, and his assistants that will be taking care of us. As you can see, there's plenty of room to be taped up during the season. There's not much of a line during game days, which is great. Then you can stay focused. We have a doctor that will take care of us and make sure that we're not playing hurt. He'll be following up with us after the games, and he'll be checking on us during the game. We have 2 full-service hot and cold tubs that we can use after practice to stay fresh. It's really a big impact during a long season.
When I met you in the summer, to my heartbeat sound, we fell in love as the leaves turn brown. And we could be together, baby, as long as skies are blue. You act so innocent now, but you lied so soon. When I met you in the summer,
Alpha Quad, where most of the dorms are located. So right here we have Brady Hall, which is an all-boys dorm. You got Dowling, all-girls dorm. Ireland Hall is right here. This is the seminary over here. You got the main chapel on campus right here. And you got Murray Herrick, which is a classroom building, and the athletic center is right there, pretty close to all the dorms. This is one of your typical doubles in Brady Hall. There are also triples and quads throughout campus. All right, this is JRC. This is one of the biggest classrooms on campus. So you know that we have smaller class sizes. We average about 20. But we use this room mainly for the football team to meet as a team during fall camp and watch videos, or we'll watch a movie occasionally. So Coach Caruso can easily address us as a whole team in here.
Here on South Campus, we have our math and science halls, and opening up this upcoming fall, we got a new engineering building being put in.
This is the heart of South Campus. So right here you have the Brady Education Center, which is used for mainly music and the arts. And right here you have the Statue of Jesus, and down below there's a grotto with a creek that leads straight to the Mississippi River. It's a nice place that you can hang out and kind of relax. Over here you have Creighton, which is an all-boys dorm, and you have Grace, which is an all-girls dorm. I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. So about a block from South Campus, we have the monument, which was dedicated to the soldiers of World War I in 1922. And it overlooks the Mississippi River, and if you look, you can see the skyline of Minneapolis around the other side. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the tour.
We hope to see you on campus real soon.